I'm going to present you a communication kit made of a whole set of tools that we developed very closely with Wau and especially with Dr. Fall. So first, let me tell you a few words on our approach, our rationale, or I could say the strategy behind these communication tools. First, if we ask ourselves, what is the objective of COVID-19 communication? It is to make people change their behavior, to make them adopt barrier measures. And people will change their behavior only if they are convinced that what is they are going to do is better for their health and the health of their children and their relatives, generally speaking. So the role of communication is to raise the level of public knowledge on COVID-19 in order for these people, for the people, to understand why they should follow the barrier measures. This is what I would call the health literacy approach. So, of course, a lot of videos, printed communication tools exist in the ECOWAS countries and otherwise in Africa. So we studied about 200 videos and printed tools. And also we used the results of more than 2 dozen of opinion polls and CAP studies in different countries. And also we reviewed what we were able to read in the online newspapers. It's based on this, all this material, then we drew some conclusions. First, there are some erroneous messages. For example, here you have two posters, and on the right is a video screen capture from material from the WHO African office. And you can see here that there is a recommendation of being careful with wild and domestic animals that are supposed to transmit the virus, and also to cook well the food and including the eggs in order to avoid transmission of the virus. And in fact, there is no infection risk, not at all, from animals in Africa, neither from meat or eggs or fish or whatever. The spillover of the coronavirus was an event in China from bats to men. We don't know exactly how, but there is no risk at all from animals in Africa. So these messages are wrong. And fortunately, it seems that they are not longer very much used. So now another problems we could identify. There are mixed messages in some communication tools. For example, here you have a poster on how to protect yourself from COVID-19 and how to do it by a better health, better food, good sleep, and so on, in order to strengthen your immune system. I don't think this is appropriate for two reasons. First, promptness is desirable in some cultures. You know, this, you know, everybody knows in Africa that being a little bit fat looks like a good health for many people. So why to go against the ideas of some people on being fat or being skinny? And second, the time to get a better immune system thanks to a better health is a time in months. It takes months. Why COVID-19 is present now, today. We have to do something today. So these mixed messages don't bring anything and can get people confused. Another issue we identified is that sometimes the design of communication tools is not appropriate. For example, here you have a poster in French where you can see somebody sneezing in his hands. So it's, the idea you get is that you have to sneeze in your hands. Or in fact, it's written here that it's something not to do. So meaning that the design goes against the message that people want to carry. other things on this same poster. Here it's written, saying good health in public transportation, while here it's shown, they show a scooter. So I show this to emphasize that good communication tools is a professional matter. It should be thoroughly thought. So another issue with some videos. Here is an example of a video. It was in French, but the idea behind this video is that we can see people who are very afraid by somebody who is coughing. And finally, this person who is coughing says, don't worry, it's nothing, it's just tuberculosis. So, meaning that this video says that tuberculosis is not a serious illness. Of course, it's really awkward. It was a video directed by a web influencer without any control, I guess, from health or communication specialists. Once more, communication tools should be made by professionals with the control of physicians. So now, the main point is that in the communication tools we studied, we noticed that there were some missing information, or some information was not frequent enough. Of course, numerous tools, and very good tools, very well done, carry the messages on bare measures, the disease, the symptoms, and so on. There are a lot of very good tools, yet some messages are missing. Some messages are not frequent enough to raise the literacy level of the people. So we are going to see three categories of messages that are either one missing or not frequent enough. First, few communication tools mention the virus. They mention the disease, COVID-19. But in fact, we don't get the disease. What we get is a virus. And this virus may cause the disease, but not always. So there is a difference. And as a matter of fact, the barrier measures are not directed against the disease, they are directed against the virus, the coronavirus. And if we want people to understand correctly the barrier measures, we have to put the virus at the center of our messages, and we have to tell them that these measures are directed against a virus. Second, few tools, very, very few tools, indicate that asymptomatic people can transmit the virus. Or it's very important to emphasize that most of the infections in the world are from asymptomatic people. Either one, people who have not been symptomatic yet, or people who will never be symptomatic. And in fact, this is the very reason for the general recommendation of the barrier measures. Otherwise, if only sick people were to transmit the virus, then we will only ask the sick people to wear a mask and to keep a distance and so on and so on. Just one thing is, this is very different from Ebola. Because with Ebola, only sick people transmit the virus. Here we are in a different situation. Third point, very few tools address the worries that keep people away from healthcare centers. And we know that this could be a huge problem because a lot of people don't go anymore to healthcare centers, don't vaccinate their children, or don't get diagnosed for diseases, or don't go see the doctors for treatment. So this might even be might even have more consequences on health than the COVID-19 itself. So based on this, with Walls and especially Dr. Fall, we designed a communication kit with proposing tools that are scientifically validated. Hand was graphics and direction for videos reinforce the messages are and also are validated. It is a comprehensive kit, meaning that we are responding to the three missing or not frequent enough themes identified before: the virus, asymptomatic transmission, and go to healthcare center. So these three issues are answered in these tools, but also, of course, these tools carry all the necessary messages about barrier measures, the symptoms, the green numbers, and so on. In the kit, you have a lot of tools. I listed them here, and we are going to see them one by one. So videos, posters, big size posters, smaller posters, and so on. First, now I am going to show you three animated videos. The first one is on COVID-19. It shows the coronavirus. It is about the symptoms, people at risk, and asymptomatic transmission. The second one is on the barrier measures, and you will see that we start from the coronavirus. We show how the virus can be transmitted to explain what the barrier measures are. And the third one is about the rumors, the wrong ideas that go around about COVID-19. We are not trying to answer this wrong ideas because it's impossible in a short video, but we are just trying to tell people, be careful and be smarter than all the rumors. Here is the first one about COVID-19.
COVID-19 is a new disease that first appeared at the end of 2019 and is today causing thousands of illnesses and deaths around the world. COVID-19 is caused by a coronavirus, a virus so small that it cannot be seen with the naked eye. Doctors and scientists are able to see it through a microscope. When someone becomes infected with the coronavirus, the person can become ill. They cough, have a fever, feel tired, and if it becomes worse, they have trouble breathing. If you have these symptoms, call your country's toll-free number right away. The disease can be serious, killing those who become sick, especially if they are elderly or already suffer from certain diseases such as diabetes or hypertension. Some people can be infected with the virus without becoming sick or just have a headache or slight cough that they don't even notice. These people who are infected with the coronavirus without becoming sick can still transmit the virus to the other people. For example, a young person in perfect health can transmit the coronavirus to their mother or father, who could become ill with the COVID-19 and could die. COVID-19, protect yourself and protect others.
The second one on the barrier measures.
COVID-19 is a disease caused by a virus called the coronavirus. This virus is spread from person to person. An infected person can transmit the virus through tiny droplets of saliva when they speak, when they cough, or when they sneeze. This is why you have to cough into your elbow and use disposable tissues. Keep a safe distance from each other. Wear a mask. And avoid crowded places as much as possible. Viruses can get on your hands. That's why you should avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth. And you should wash your hands frequently. This is why you shouldn't shake hands. You can spread the coronavirus without being sick. That's why everybody must take precautions, even people who are not sick. If you become sick, stay home, wear a mask, and call the toll-free number for your country. COVID-19, protect yourself and protect others.
And here is the third one.
There is no treatment available in modern medicine to prevent you from getting infected with the coronavirus or becoming ill. Taking medicine without a prescription, however, can make you sick. No home remedy or traditional medicine can prevent you from becoming infected or getting sick. Drink tea? Why not? But the coronavirus doesn't care. It can still infect you. Pepper soup won't impress the virus either. Garlic changes the way your breath smells, but it won't protect you from COVID-19. You can shave your beard to change your looks, but coronavirus likes clean-shaving guys as much as those with beards. Disinfectant work well on surfaces or your hands, but if you swallow them, they will burn the inside of your body without protecting you from COVID-19. Not everything you hear from word of mouth or social media about COVID-19 is true. Always check the information. Let's be smarter than all the rumors about COVID-19. Only way to protect yourself against COVID-19 is to adopt the barrier measures.
I would say again, as you noticed, we first explain that there is a virus, and second, we explain that this virus can cause disease in the first video. And the second one, we explain how to protect oneself and others against this virus. Now, we also propose three videos based on interviews with Dr. Landré Falodun from Nigeria. These three videos have the same follow the same patterns of the three animated videos. The first one is on what is COVID-19. The second one is how to protect yourself from COVID-19. And the third one is, again, on the rumors and the wrong ideas on COVID-19. You can see they are short, a little bit over 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes. Now, we propose three billboard-sized posters. Here is the first one. You can see here that we explain that the virus is the causes of the illness. And we also say that even people without any symptoms can transmit the virus. Second billboard-sized poster, on barrier measures. The third one is to tell people to keep going to health centers, either one to get their children vaccinated for regular medical visits, for diagnostics, or for example, for prenatal visit. Now, we propose four posters. They have more text, there is more writing in them, but they are in a smaller size, but they are designed to be put in places where people have a little bit of time to read. For example, working homes, in schools, in hospitals, in railway stations, and at work, for example. So the first one is about the disease and the virus that causes the disease, and about the way to transmit the virus. As you can see here, again, we explain that there is a virus going from one person to another person. The second one on how to protect yourself, the barrier measures. And the third one, go to health, keep going to the health centers. Again, for vaccination and so on. And the fourth one is on the wrong ideas, the rumors, the fake treatments, and various supposed kinds of protection. Now, we also propose a flyer on the first page, what is COVID-19 with the symptoms? And again, we say that some people who have no symptoms can transmit the virus. And on the second page, the second page is on the barrier measures. And you can see here, we explain the causes, the way of transmission. And here we explain the barrier measures for each way of transmission. Now we have a Q&A designed for NGO members, health workers, maybe teachers. So we kept it short because I don't think a Q&A that has 10 pages is very useful because people don't go through 10 pages. So it's simple and short. Now here a slide on how you can obtain and adapt the kit, I mean all these tools for your country or your organization. So for the ECOWAS countries, write to Babacar, but I know that Babacar has already sent the kit to the different countries. For other countries, you can send me a mail and I will send you the tools. These tools can be adapted. We can include in them the local green numbers and also the logos, for example, logo of the Ministry of Health of the country. We can also edit them in local languages. For this, you can get in touch with Babacar.